The 2024 edition of Google I/O is currently in progress, and as anticipated, the new version of Flutter, Flutter 3.22, has been announced. This release includes several exciting new features, such as the inclusion of WebAssembly for faster web pages, the experimental addition of Dart macros to replace code generation tools, significant enhancements to the Impeller graphics engine, and much, much more. So, sit back and let's dive into the main improvements in Flutter 3.22. Flutter 3.22 now includes the ability to build a Flutter app for the web using WebAssembly, or WASM for short. WASM is a new open standard that defines a binary format, enabling code to run in its binary form in browsers. This results in a significant improvement in application performance. For instance, here is the Wanderers app running in Safari, which does not yet support WebAssembly. Now, look at the same website running in a Chromium browser that supports WASM. As you can see, this technology is very promising for all of us working with Flutter web. However, it's important to note that there are still some limitations in its support, and not all browsers support it in the same way. Nevertheless, we now have this option available in the stable channel. With the release of Flutter 3.22, the experimental ability to start using macros has also been announced. So, what are macros? Essentially, they are a form of metaprogramming that generates code by analyzing other code at compile time. Let's see it in action for a better understanding. In this example, I have a class called LoginRequest that I want to convert to JSON format. Currently, we could use the JSON serializable package, create the necessary code, and use buildRunner to generate the additional code for the toJSON and fromJSON methods. In the future, we will be able to use the JSON codable macro to achieve the same goal in a much more elegant way. Note that the toJSON method does not exist yet. By annotating the class with a JSON codable annotation, the toJSON method will be automatically generated. Macros are not yet considered stable. However, they will undoubtedly be a great feature when they are released to simplify development cycles. Now, let's briefly discuss Flutter's new graphics engine, Impeller. In this version, the implementation of the Vulkan backend for Impeller is considered complete. With Flutter 3.22, you can optionally enable Impeller. If your app runs on a device that supports Vulkan, Impeller will be used. If the device only supports OpenGL, Skia will be used instead, without any additional action required from you. The work on Impeller for Android is not entirely finished, so it is important to perform tests and report any rendering errors encountered when testing with Impeller. Additionally, this new version brings Impeller-related bug fixes and further performance improvements. We look forward to using Impeller on Android soon to take advantage of its enhanced performance. Another improvement in Flutter 3.22 is the ability to obtain much more detailed information on form errors. For example, in a form with two text fields, instead of using the validate method, you can now use validate granularly. This method provides a set of elements with detailed information about each error for each form field. This allows you to address specific errors individually, see the number of errors, and improve the usability and clarity of the forms in your application. In the Android section, Flutter 3.22 brings several significant improvements, starting with enhanced support for deep linking. Flutter 3.19 introduced a validation tool in DevTools to check web configuration in Android applications. Now, Flutter 3.22 includes new features that help verify this setup in the Android manifest files. Additionally, this version improves support for the predictive bug gesture, a new Android feature that allows users to preview the previous route or app while navigating. Flutter 3.22 introduces greater Kotlin DSL support for better code editing, fixes a bug affecting native components on Android 14, and ends support for Android KitKat, raising the minimum supported version to Lollipop, which is the API 21. Additionally, this update enhances the reliability and performance of platform views on Android. Regarding iOS, Flutter 3.22 brings a significant performance improvement for platform views, especially within scrollable elements. If your app contains such components, you might already be aware of the issues involved. With this update, the performance and visual quality of these components should see a notable enhancement. Let's now discuss the new version of the Mobile Ads SDK plugin. Version 5.0.1 of the plugin includes enhancements to the user messaging platform, which is Google's consent management tool. This update supports the latest features, making it easier to obtain user consent for serving ads to the users of the European Union. Additionally, the mediation support has expanded to include more partners such as Unity, Meta, AppLovin, and others. That's it for this quick roundup of the most interesting news about Flutter 3.22. If you want to explore the rest of the updates and announcements from this year's Google I/O, check out the links in the description of this video. Leave me a like if you enjoyed this video and subscribe to my channel for more Flutter content. I hope you have a beautiful rest of your day. Goodbye.